class, we are going to start with the topic conjunctions. Okay, now come here, Pragati. Come here, bring your notebook. Come here. So start writing it here, something. Just do the action. See here this girl. Okay, Kritika, come here. You also come here. Okay, you just suppose deliver a speech. Speak anything. Come here, both of you. So now speak anything. Good morning, I'm Kritika of this class. Speak. To the students, speak in front of students, speak louder.
Good morning, I'm Kritika.
Speak on topic honesty.
Honesty is very important for every person. We cannot live without it. Honesty is the best policy.
Okay, so now these two girls are present here in front of you. What are they doing? What Pragati is doing? Pragati is writing in the notebook. And what Kritika is doing?
She is
speaking speech. Now I want to join these two sentences. Please go to your seats. Okay. Suppose the first sentence is Pragati is writing and Kritika is delivering the speech. So these two girls are doing two different actions. Now I want to join these two sentences. Okay, I don't want to write down separately. I want to join them in one sentence. Okay, so Amil, speak out the answer. And Kritika is delivering the speech. So Pragati is writing while Kritika is delivering the speech. Kritika is delivering the speech. So I have joined these two sentences. Okay. Suppose, what you drink in the morning? Milk. Okay. And what you drink in the evening? Tea. Suppose both are your favorites. You like or tea. If I want to just say that I like both of them, how will you say tea and coffee are my favorite beverages? Or are I like tea and coffee? Right? Both tea and coffee, right? Okay? Jagjot, pay attention. So it means that here I'm joining two words, that is tea and coffee. And here I'm joining two different sentences. So now see this does. How many parts it has? It has this front part, these two side parts. How are they joined? These are different parts, okay? But how it is making a dice? How it is dice? Because these different parts are joined together. These different parts are joined together to formulate. Beta, move your desk forward, please. Little more. Now sit. So it means that different parts of word, they are joined together and to formulate a dice. Okay, this table. It has a top and it has a sitting place. When they are joined together, it formulates a complete bench. Means something is required to join them. How these parts of wood, they are joined together? If I give you two parts of wood to join them, how will you join them? With glue? And in case of wood, it is Fevicol? Okay. So here, this conjunction, it is doing the job of Fevicol. Remember this. You need to join words, but to words you can use Fevicol to join words. I think that you will take this sentence, put favicol and then write down other sentence. It is possible? No, it is not at all possible. Then what is required in case of English to join them? This is called as conjunction. Okay, so what is required in order to join words or sentences? It is called as conjunction. So now you got what is conjunction?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let us write down the definition of conjunction. You have written these examples in your FAIR notebooks. Write down first of all these examples. Write down these examples. Yes, write down. Pragati is writing. Kritika is delivering the speech. Now we have joined. You have written, beta? Okay. Pragati is writing while Kritika is delivering the speech. Okay. So now, here it is this while. This is what? This is conjunction. So what is conjunction is? A conjunction is a word. Remember what this word we will call? Favicol. Okay? Yes, write down definition. Conjunction is a word that is used to join words. That is used to join words. Words, group of words or sentences. Group of words or sentences. Okay. Right? They are also called as linkers or connectors. They are also called as linkers or connectors. They are also called as linkers or connectors. Right? Okay. Now you got what is a conjunction? Okay. So who will tell me what is conjunction? Yes, you can tell me what is conjunction now. To join two words. Two sentences also or group of words. Linkers. They link. Yes, of course they link. Yes, right. Okay. So now is it clear? What are conjunctions? Jagjot, it is clear? Got now? Okay. So whenever conjunction is mentioned, just remember the one word that is called as favicol. And remember the example which is given by me, that is of this does. Clear now? So these are conjunctions. Okay. So mainly there are two type of conjunctions. Conjunctions are of two types. Which are main types? That is coordinating and subordinating conjunctions. Coordinating and subordinating conjunctions. What are the two types of conjunctions? That is coordinating and subordinating conjunctions, right? There are two types of conjunctions. Now, I am rubbing it down first. First is, what are coordinating conjunctions? Coordinating conjunctions. Coordinating, see here now. Now, when you have two guests in your home, okay, mainly two main guests are One is your father, sister, that is your Bhuaji, aunt, and the another one is your mother, sister. Both are of equal rank. Okay, like that of your Bhua is your father's sister and your Masi is your mother's sister. It means both are of equal rank. To whom you will give more importance? Equal importance to both. Okay, so here in case of coordinating conjunctions also, when these conjunctions join sentences of equal rank, okay, or two independent sentences. Okay, so then what are they called as? They are called as coordinating conjunctions. Okay, conjunctions which join sentences of equal rank. Or independent sentences. Then what are these called as? These are called as coordinating conjunctions. They are called as coordinating conjunctions. Suppose I write down, the cold wind blows or the door opens and cold wind blows. So here the door opens, it is complete in its meaning. See these two part of sentences. Cold wind blows and the door opens. These two are equal. If I speak these two sentences individually, the door opens, it has its meaning. Yes, the door opens. Nothing is incomplete. And the second one is cold wind blows. Again, it is open. There is no, you can say, incompleteness in these two sentences. It means that when both the sentences are complete in their meaning, then they are independent sentences. The other example which I have given, like Pragati is writing and Kritika is speaking. These two are independent. They are not depending on each other to complete their meaning. So these are also example of coordinating conjunctions. These are also examples of coordinating conjunctions. What are these? These are also examples of coordinating conjunctions, right? Now next, further, we have to revise. Okay, we have to see that what are different parts of coordinating conjunctions also. Okay, you just understand all these. No, in this manner they won't be there, right types, no. I'm just making you understand the topic. Next are types of coordinating. Yes, write down types of coordinating conjunctions. What are the types of coordinating conjunctions? Okay. First is a part is cumulative. First part is cumulative conjunctions. Now, what are cumulative conjunctions? Cumulative conjunctions are those conjunctions that add one statement to other. They add one statement to other. Okay, what they do? They add on one statement to other. For example, like we say, and, both, okay, as well as, no, not so. So is subordinating conjunction. So is subordinating conjunction. No, cumulative nahi hai beta wo. No, these are as is there. Okay, as can be there. So now just see what are cumulative. Okay, suppose the boy stood and asked to drink, or can also be there, right? Or, okay, so now means they are adding one fact to another. Okay, whether no, whether nahi aayega. For example, see, both loyalty and honesty are good qualities. Both loyalty and honesty are good qualities. It means I am adding loyalty to honesty when something is added. Okay, right? So for example, Harshita opened the camera and clicked the photograph. So what is this? It is adding one statement to another. Okay, when we add on one statement to another, then it is an example of cumulative conjunctions. Okay, right? For example, Ritam is a good writer as well as a good singer also. Okay, it means that it means that I'm adding on qualities of Ritam. Okay, right? Or Somil is both intelligent and hardworking. I'm adding on qualities, right? So when we are adding on one thing to another, this is what? This is an example of cumulative. Cumulate means to add. Cumulate means to add, okay? No, paper mein, for example, you will get fill conjunctions. Fill conjunction. Join sentences with the help of conjunction. We will do the exercise afterwards. Next, afterwards, we are having B part, that is, we are having adversative conjunctions. Next, we are having adversative conjunctions. Adversative conjunctions. Now, what are adversative conjunctions? Adversative conjunctions, write down. Yes, what they show? To show contrast. To show contrast. Contrast means here to in cumulative we have added on. Okay, here we have when we have to show two opposite qualities. Okay, two opposite qualities. For example, but, still and yet, while. Okay. But a while is included in subordinating. While will be subordinating. Okay. Whereas. Yet I have already written. Okay. Right. Suppose. No, that is subordinating conjunction. I will tell you how. That is although is subordinating of adverb clause. Okay. So now see here. But for example, see here but. No, it is also of adverb clause, subordinating. I will come to that point. You yourself will say, yes, it is subordinating. Equal, balance hota, yes. We thank you very much. Huh? Neither? No, that is afterwards we are doing. Okay, correlative conjunctions. Because pairs mein hai na wo. Right? So, wo different category hai. So, now see here, adversity means when? We are doing two different type of sentences. Okay. So for example, her sister is intelligent, but her younger brother is. Okay. What? Raina bought a bracelet, but she did not wear it. Raina bought a bracelet is complete in its sense. She did not wear it. It's also complete in its sense. But opposite situations ho gayi na. I like that dress. But I did not purchase it. Okay. This is what? Opposite ho gayi na situations. Both the situations are opposite. I played the guitar.
My friend sang.
But here conjunction is missing.
While
yes, then it will be subordinating. Okay, then it will be subordinating. Okay, it means that when we have opposite two contrasting situations are there, then which conjunction we will use? We will use adversative conjunction. But, okay, still yet, okay, right? For example, the weather was cold, yet we enjoyed the picnic. Okay, or still, yet or still mein slash dalo, not dash. Put slash in still or yet, okay, right? Okay, there were few students in the class, still we enjoyed the lecture. Okay, it means opposites, opposite situations are there. Huh? Because is again that of adverb clause, subordinating conjunction. Subordinating conjunction. Huh? Wo negative, one positive and one negative. Right? Okay. So next is we are having a third part. We are having alternative conjunctions. Next we are having alternative conjunctions. C part is alternative conjunctions. Now what are alternative conjunctions? See here. Here, what are they giving? Name indicates that what are they giving? They are giving us an alternative. Okay. Requires a choice. It requires a choice. Yes, or aega. Or either or neither nor. Huh? Else, okay, else or otherwise or else. See here, or example with or. Would you like to have tea or coffee? Option aa gayi na, choice is there. Yes, very good, choice is there. It requires a choice, it presents a choice, because name is alternative. Alternative means to give a choice, right? Or for example, I'm free now. I would like to go for a movie or shopping with my mother. Choice is there. Either you go for shopping or for a movie. Neither you nor he will go outside the class. What is this? Choice is there. Otherwise, sit here. Otherwise, you will not be allowed to go outside. Choice or else. Yes, okay, right? So when choice is there, what is there? Choice. When choice is there, so then which type of conjunctions they are? They are alternative conjunctions. Huh? Else, okay, work hard, else you will not get good marks, right? Else, you have to submit the documents, else you will not get the certificate. As is that of comparison, right? Next we have next part, that is elative conjunctions. D part is we have elative conjunctions. What we have next? We have elative conjunctions. What we have? We have elative conjunctions. Last three boys, pay attention. Next we have which type of conjunctions? That is elative conjunctions. Now elative conjunction means, okay, when a fact or conclusion is drawn on the basis of another fact on the basis of another fact. Okay. For example, for, therefore, and so. It means that one action happened and as a result of it, the another happened. Okay, right? For example, we listen regularly in the class for we want to get good marks. What is this? We listen regularly in the class is complete in its sense. For is conjunction. We want to get good marks in exam. What is this? This is also independent. Just remember when we are writing coordinating conjunctions mean both the sentences will be of equal rank, independent one. Okay, just remember this. Okay, and when we are joining one sentence of both the sentences of unequal rank, then these will be subordinating conjunction. This we will do further. Okay, so we work hard so that we can excel in life. Okay, we are writing in the notebook, therefore the teacher is appreciating us. For example, for, therefore, and so. Elative means when one is drawn because of the result of the other fact. Suppose why you are writing in notebook? Give answer to me why you are writing in notebook. So you can revise. I'm writing in notebook, or so that I'm writing in notebook. Okay, so that I can revise the things better. Okay, so it means, for example, we are listening in the class or we are writing in the notebook, therefore my notebook is very nice. It means one result is because of the first sentence. One fact, result of one fact, it is derived because of the another sentence. Okay, so these are the examples of coordinating conjunctions. Right, so after coordinating conjunctions, we will have subordinating conjunctions. Okay, subordinating conjunctions. No. In paper, you will not get in this types. No, your sentence will be given in the form of blank fill conjunction. But you should know the detail of the topic, right? Okay, fill conjunction, join these two sentences with the help of conjunction. In this manner, you will get. Okay, so now these are conjunctions that you have to do in your fair notebook. Okay, after this, we will have the topic of subordinating conjunctions in the next class. Okay, so in the next class, we will have subordinating conjunctions.